Let's read the question, students. Select the correct statement. On dilution, molar conductivity increases, conductivity decreases. On dilution, molar conductivity decreases, while conductivity increases. On dilution, both molar conductivity and conductivity increases. And on dilution, both molar conductivity and conductivity decreases. Student, this is something very easy. As we all know that on dilution, the value of molar conductivity increases and the value of conductivity or specific conductance decreases. That means the correct answer is option number one. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 87. Let's read the question, students. During the electrolysis of aqueous sodium chloride using platinum electrode, the time required to produce 1 mole of H2 gas using a current of 1 ampere is. Students, for this question, first of all, I'm writing the reaction of the formation of H2 gas during electrolysis of aqueous sodium chloride using platinum electrode. Since the formation takes place at cathode, so I'm writing the reaction that occurs at cathode only. So it gives 2H2O liquid plus 2 electron gives 2OH minus plus H2 gas. So this is very clear that for 1 mole of H2 gas, 2 Faraday charge is required. Also, we know that Q is equals to IT. Since Q is 2 into F, that is 2 into 96500, the value of I is already given 1 ampere. And the value of time we have to calculate in seconds. Students, here the time that is calculated will be in second. But in the options, we can see that the time is given in R. So we have to convert directly the time into R. So time is equals to 2 multiplied by 96500 divided by 3600, that is 16 to 60. So we can directly convert the time into hours. I am directly multiplying and dividing the term. This will be 53.61 R. That means the correct answer is option number 3. Students, don't use calculator. Try with yourself. Take time. Do the calculations by yourself. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 88. Let's read the question. Select the correct option among the following for aluminium sulfate solution at infinite dilution. Students, in this question, we are given with the relation between limiting molar conductivity of aluminium ion and sulfate ion. Also, the relation between equivalent conductivity and molar conductivity. We have to identify that which is the correct option. Students, for this question, we need to know that the limiting molar conductivity is equals to N factor multiplied by limiting equivalent conductivity. Also, we are given with aluminium sulfate, and for aluminium sulfate, the ions produced is 2Al3 plus plus 3SO4 2 minus. Student, also we know that limiting molar conductivity of aluminium sulfate, that is Al2SO4 whole 3, is equals to 2 multiplied by limiting molar conductivity of aluminium ion plus 3 into limiting molar conductivity of sulfate ion. Also, this is equals to 6 into limiting equivalent conductivity of aluminium sulfate, that is Al2SO4 whole 3. Now, student, we know that the limiting equivalent conductivity of Al2SO4 whole 3 is equals to limiting equivalent conductivity of aluminium ion plus limiting equivalent conductivity of sulfate ion. If we have to convert this into molar conductivity, we have to divide by N factor. So limiting molar conductivity of Al3 plus upon 3 is equals to limiting equivalent conductivity of aluminium 3 plus plus limiting molar conductivity of sulfate ion upon 2. Student, by the entire terms we have discussed here, it is very clear that among the given options, the correct option is option number 2, that is limiting molar conductivity of aluminium sulfate is equals to 6 into limiting equivalent conductivity of aluminium sulfate. That means the correct answer is option number 2. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 89. Let's read the question. Standard free energies of formation in joule per mole at 298 Kelvin are minus X, minus Y and minus Z for H2O, CO2 and CH4 respectively. The value of E0 cell in volts for methane oxygen fuel cell is. Standard free energies of formation in joule per mole at 298 Kelvin is minus X, minus Y and minus Z for H2O, CO2 and CH4 respectively. The value of E0 cell in volts for methane oxygen fuel cell is. Students, for this question, first of all, I'm writing the reaction, which is CH4 gaseous plus 2O2 gaseous gives CO2 gaseous plus 2H2O liquid. Here, the oxidation state of carbon is minus 4 and here this is plus 4. That means the value of N is 8. Now, students, let's proceed with the value of delta G. So, delta R G naught is equals to free energies of products minus free energies of reactant. So, here we are given with free energies of H2O as minus X, CO2 as Y. So, this is minus Y plus 2 into minus X, since here the water is in 2 moles. And then we have to subtract the free energy is the formation of reactant. So for CH4, the free energy is minus Z. So minus Z. And for O2, the free energy is 0. So plus 2 into 0. That means minus Y minus 2X plus Z joules per mole. Now, student, we know that delta G naught is equals to minus NF E naught cell. We know the value of delta G naught, which is equals to Z minus Y minus 2X. We know the value of N, we have already calculated. So, minus 8. The value of F must be taken as F. We can see here. The value of E naught cell, we have to calculate into E naught cell. That means E naught cell is equals to 2X plus Y minus Z upon 8F. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 1. Moving to next question, students, which is question number 90. Let's read the question, students. If KCl is doped with 10 raised to the power minus 3 mole percent AlCl3, then the number of cation vacancies produced in 10 mole KCl will be. Students, for this question, first of all, we'll need to know that 1 mole of Al3+ produce 2 mole of cation vacancies. Since here this is K plus and here this is Al3 plus. So 1 mole of Al3 plus will produce 2 mole of cation vacancies. And here it's given that 100 mole of KCl. Here it is given that 100 mole of KCl is doped with 10 raised to the power minus 3 mole of AlCl3. That means 10 mole of KCl is doped with 10 raised to the power minus 4 mole of AlCl3. Also, it is very clear that 1 mole of Al3+ will produce 2 mole of cationic vacancies. That means 10 raised to the power minus 4 mole of AlCl3 will produce, I'm writing it, 10 raised to the power minus 4 mole of AlCl3 will develop 2 multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 4 multiplied by Na cationic vacancies Let's multiply this 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. Let's put the value of Na here. 6.022 into 10 raised to the power minus 23. Let's multiply this. We'll get 12.04 into 10 raised to the power 19 cationic vacancies. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 1. That was the last question, students. I hope this quick solution is really helpful for you people. All the very best. Be prepared, be strong, and be safe.